5:30 in the morning might not sound like the time you want to get up when you're on holiday, but this is definitely worth it. Just take a look over there. South Africa is arguably one of the best places in the world to come and see some of the most amazing wildlife. I've come to Mala Mala Game Reserve, which is home to thousands of animals, including the cheetah. We must be about 10 metres away, and this is probably one of the best things I've ever seen in the harvest.
The great thing about being on safari is that all you have to do is sit back and wait for the wildlife to appear.
That's close enough.
And sometimes this can be very close indeed. There's quite a set routine when you come on safari. It's a very early morning start when you go on a game drive. You lounge around a lot eating nice food before another game drive in the evening, and it's a wonderful experience.
One of the biggest problems disabled people have when they go away is access to transport. And on a safari, this is very important. If you can make a high transfer, then the vehicles aren't a problem at all, but you might need to get some assistance. There's lots of people around to help. You just need to explain what you need to do.
Oh, that's great. Lovely, thanks very much.
All right, here you go.
The Mala Mala is a private game reserve, which has given a lot of thought to wheelchair access, so getting around was very easy, and the facilities were impressive.
Welcome to the accommodation. This is the first of the three bathrooms that I've got. This one's been specially adapted for wheelchair users. There's loads of grab rails around the toilet, a lowered sink, and a mirror that you can actually see your face in. Coming through to the bedroom, again, you've got loads and loads of space and the biggest bed that I've ever seen in my life. There are two pools here at Mala Mala. This one's accessible, although the ramp's a little bit steep, but as with the rest of the place, there's always lots of people to help you get down. It's a bit cold, and as long as you don't mind sharing it with frogs, it's fine.
It's freezing.
I found the safari part of my holiday was just a perfect time to relax and go along with a heavy traffic congestion.
Going on safari is a holiday of a lifetime in itself, but I'm about to embark on one of the great train journeys of the world. From Pretoria to Cape Town, it's the Blue Train. So I guess it's all aboard. Well, this is the height of luxury. Each room has its own television set to show the direction of travel, have an accessible bathroom, a remote control for your blinds, and even your own personal mobile phone to call for your butler.
Access on the train is generally quite good, although the corridors are slightly narrow. They can provide a wheelchair, which is a perfect fit for the corridor, if yours isn't.
If you like food, you'll love the Blue Train. It's a constant feast, and the highlight being afternoon tea.
As part of the journey, you can visit the diamond mining town of Kimberley. This involves an inaccessible coach and an inaccessible tram. But if you can manage that, then you get the opportunity to look for a diamond of your own.
Look. Oh, right. Oh, I didn't look very carefully, did I?
No, you didn't. And let me see. Ah, that's a little diamond that you'll win.
Oh, lovely.
Hey.
Oh, very nice.
Thank you.
Here you are. It's a big diamond.
Back on the train, it's time to get ready for dinner. And while you're away from your room, your bed will be made up for your return. After over 24 hours on the Blue Train, I arrived at Cape Town and met up with Lauren Singer, who works for the Enabled Traveller Project, which checks out the accessibility of Cape Town's tourist attractions.
So is the waterfront accessible?
Extremely. Extremely accessible. The rest of Cape Town, it depends where you want to go, but the environs of the wine route...
That's very important.
That's very important, and that is also accessible. It would depend on which wine farm you wanted to go on, so you'd have to do a little bit of research into that.
So there's plenty of things to do here, including an accessible trip to Robben Island, where Nelson Mandela was imprisoned. For the more daring amongst you, there's Rollability, a group of disabled people who organises accessible activities. On a trip to the top of Table Mountain, I met Gavin Maggot, who works for Rollability.
We do bungee jumping, we've done skydiving, we've also done scuba diving, which is great.
So what's the scariest thing you've done?
The scariest thing was skydiving, because you free fall for about 8,000 feet, and that was great.
Yeah. I'll take your word for that one.
We organised this holiday through Journeys by Design. On the good side, the trip took me to the top-notch highlights of South Africa. On the downside, there were a few places where there were steps. But bear in mind that access in South Africa often means being helped, so these obstacles were surmountable. We also had a few scheduling problems, but they didn't stop us having a great time.
My holiday in South Africa is at an end, and it's been an amazing experience without too many access worries. Before I go, I better have one last sip of South African wine. Cheers.